Ladies and gentlemen, Minecraft Live is over, but we got a bunch of new information regarding Minecraft Legends. And all I can really say is I'm really excited and really cannot wait to be able to play this game. I originally streamed my reaction to some of the announcements and things Mojang showed during Minecraft Live, and I thought, you know what, let me make this part into a video. So yeah, I'm gonna hand you over to Past Live B, and I hope to see you in the next one. Enjoy the video. Yeah, I think this is the cinematic trailer, in-game cinematic, that's going to be in the intro or in the start of the game or something like that. We're gonna look at this right now and see what this is and how it looks. Let's go. Minecraft Legends. We got a baby villager, it looks like. Saying hello to a turtle. I was about to say, I have feelings I'm gonna say as peaceful. Okay, let's go. Whole piglin. Looks so confused. Oh. That was brutal. That was savage. Okay. Okay. Whoa. I love these animations.
Okay then. Action, knowledge, come with me. We must witness this together.
What was that weird thing with four eyes?
Action, knowledge, come with me. We must witness this together.
Okay, coming spring 2023. This is gonna be on the channel right here. Well, with that, let us jump into Minecraft Live 2022, Minecraft Legends first look and demo.
Legends hold great power. The legends we hold dearest are legends of hope, of creativity,
yes,
and of bravery.
Indeed.
And friendships. That change the world forever.
What, those baby creepers? Okay. I guess that's the player
this
right there.
This is the legend of a united overworld. United by you.
Minecraft Legends is a brand new action strategy game from us at Mojang Studios in partnership with Blackbird Interactive. And I'm here with two of my amazing colleagues. Hey, Magnus. Hey, Kevin.
Hello.
And you're really bringing the spirit of our original Minecraft game and the feeling of, you know, you're like, we're in this beautiful place. It's different than Minecraft, but it's something special. Where are we?
Oh, the set, I didn't even realize. I was wondering, it looked a little bit off. The set is actually supposed to be Minecraft Legends, not Minecraft in of itself. You can see that from the tower. And I love the sets Mojang actually pull off.
A little familiar still, but welcome to the Well of Fate. The Well of Fate is where we start our adventure in Minecraft Legends. It's where you enter the world. It's really the heart of the overworld in this story. And it's a place where, over the course of the game, you're going to make some very important friends.
Yeah, when you come to the Well of Fate in the beginning of a game, you will be given a couple of tools that kind of gives you your ability in this world and in this game. So to begin with, you get the thing called the Flame of Creation.
Well, I mean, I don't need to know anything else. That's just so
that's
cool.
What you want to have, right?
It's awesome.
Agreed.
The Flame of Creation is kind of like making it possible for you to build spawners that can bring new friends into the world that helps you out. Second thing you will be given is the Banner of Courage. And that's a banner that you can wave in the air and that will make your friends follow you. And then you can point them in different directions and tell them to do different tasks for you.
That's cool.
And maybe the last but not least, my favorite, the loot. You are given a loot that you can play and that, you know, just play some music and that will bring in the allies into the world. They love music and they will help you to gather materials and build buildings and stuff in this world.
Cool, and everybody's going to get to see a lot of that as we play through and show a lot more of Minecraft Legends than people have seen before.
Okay.
So there's a lot of mobs who will show up and be very curious about the hero. There's a little turtle following the hero there. Some of the mobs will be familiar to players of Minecraft already. But there will be some new little faces in there as well. And like I said, most of these creatures will be curious and will follow you around and start to learn about you. But some of them may help out a little bit. For example, our friend the llama. Turns out llamas really don't like piglins. And you know what happens if you make a llama mad. As soon as you arrive in the world at the Well of Fate, like I said, you will meet some friends called the hosts. And the hosts are interesting characters.
Interesting indeed. One with four eyes, one with an ogre looking thing with one eye holding a thing that looks like that has either a very bad hair day or a helmet. Okay, is that a shulker? I don't know.
That you'll get to know across the course of the game, and on screen there's a shot of them. Is on the left the tall one is Foresight, on the right the little one is Knowledge, and the middle is Action. And Foresight, Knowledge, and Action are the characteristics, when we started thinking about these characters, that we think all Minecraft players, we all demonstrate every time we play Minecraft, is we see a hill and foresight is coming up with a dream of what might be up there. Knowledge is the understanding of the crafting recipes and the ingredients that you need to make that real. And then action is the oomph, it's the hard work to make that a reality. So foresight, knowledge, and action will help you across the course of the game.
That's actually a really fun way of integrating like the mechanics of Minecraft into a game story, if that makes sense. I love that.
Hopefully become your friends.
I really love that. And Jens actually headed into Legends to meet up with the hosts so that you can all get to know them more.
Ooh, okay. Gameplay or cinematic stuff, something, maybe, who knows?
Welcome back, Jens. What can I do for you today?
You're always so helpful, Foresight. We've been friends for a while, and I felt it was time to return the favor.
Thank you.
Anything I can do to help you with that?
Your timing is perfect. Let us hope your courage is as well. Come, action waits for us through the portal.
Okay.
Action!
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 Action?
Where are you? Oh, hello. Nice little kitten.
Hello.
Oh, action. It's good to see you.
I'm glad you're back. We really need help protecting the overworld. Do you know anything about that?
Maybe a thing or two.
Good. Somebody has to help us put an end to this.
I appreciate all the confidence, but we might need a few more reinforcements.
You think? What's that thing? Oh dear.
The piglins are moving faster than we thought. We need more time.
Knowledge, what should we do?
Right now, we run!
Right.
Eh? That was unexpected.
Surprise!
Ah, oh my.
Oh.
Red skies. That means more piglins.
Oh, damn.
That means it's time for us to actually jump into the game. Pete, we're going to start exploring with you, so let's jump in.
Let's do it.
Ooh. Okay. Cut, pause, everything. I want to analyze. We got a map. We got maybe a quest book. A compass at the top here. We got building blocks or resources down here. I assume lapis, diamond, gold, diamond. Lapis, emerald, gold, diamond, redstone, coal, iron, stone, wood. We got resource gatherers. We got builders, I assume, because of the pickaxe and the hammer. We got a hotbar. We got, I think, tools, it seems. We got the pickaxe right here to maybe gather, mine stuff. We got this to pull out a sword. Maybe these two for something else. We got this, which is... I don't know what that is. Nor do I know what that is. Nor do I know what that is. But so far, this is looking very nice indeed.
Come on. Who is that cool, cool animal?
Yes, I want one.
This here is the regal tiger. It's one of the many new mobs that you'll see in Minecraft Legends, and it's one of the few that you'll be able to ride.
That's so cool. And throughout the game, you're always riding on one, and this one looks really fast.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. That's one of the reasons why it's my favorite, and also because it's so adorable.
It is really adorable. So where are we going to go?
Well, I got a couple things planned. We should be heading over to help the rest of the team battle a piglin base. But there was a few things that I wanted to show off first.
Right.
I see the Well of Fate.
Yeah, you sure do. So this is the Well of Fate, as you mentioned. It is the player's home away from home when they're in the world of Legends. It's where you start the adventure and you return here many times throughout the course of the game, so you'll become very familiar with it by the end.
Okay.
It's so beautiful. I love how peaceful and nice it is here.
Yeah, that's the idea. So actually, here,
it is very peaceful.
Scoop up some friends.
So you're using the Banner of Courage?
That's right. You just wave it around whenever there's a friendly mob nearby, and they'll follow you around.
Wait, hold on.
Right? You just wave it around.
Okay, that's the Q button. That's the flag button down here. Okay.
Whenever there's a friendly mob nearby, and they'll follow you around. So we're going to get animals going here.
Ooh, nice. Yeah, quite a bunch of cuties.
Yeah, that's right. We're going to take them for a swim just for fun.
Okay, so they're coming with you for fun, but not to fight.
That's right. I mean, look at that pig's face. Would you send that face into battle?
No, definitely not.
True.
I would protect it, though. I'm ready.
So I had a couple more things I wanted to show. First off, with the allays, I'm going to ask the allays to gather this tree for me.
That's really cool.
Yeah, you can see him tearing down that tree.
And then one is doing the job, and the number has been reduced to four.
Players will be familiar with vanilla Minecraft, breaking down the world and rebuilding it block by block. In Legends, we like to say that you do that thought by thought. So the player just has to say, you know what, I need some wood, and then you ask the lays to gather it for you, and off they go.
That's so amazing. So they will stay there and just keep gathering as you go about your journey.
That's right. You can send them off to gather resources while you do more important things.
They're really nice friends.
Awesome.
They sure are. They sure are. So right over here is the next thing I wanted to show off. This is very similar to the bounce caps that you and Magnus were talking about. These sparkling bushes in front of me are called speedweed. Now, the player just needs to touch these and they'll get a speed boost. So we're going to use these here to rip through a few biomes and head over to the team battling the piglins.
Nice.
Off we go. Wow.
Oh, we're really fast now.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
Wow. That's fast.
So we're heading into the jungle here. We're going to hit some more speedweed, and then we're going to hit these bounce caps here. So we're going to be super fast and jump super high.
Wow.
Maybe some of our little cuties will catch up, but we'll see.
Yeah.
We might be too fast and too jumpy for them.
Yeah, we're not making it easy on them, but I have faith that they'll be able to keep up.
Whoa, this is gorgeous.
Really is.
Yeah, it's one of my favorite biomes. It's partially because of how much fun it is to run across the treetops like I'm doing here.
Uh-huh.
Also just because of how nice it looks.
Oh, it's beautiful. And the mangroves are there.
Yeah, that's right. So I wanted to show off this nice bird's eye view. Here we go.
That's awesome.
Jungle. You can see all the beautiful trees and stuff.
And the world is randomly generated, so it's always going to be a bit different.
That's right. Everyone's world will be different. The world is just like it is in vanilla Minecraft, where, you know, from one player to the next, the world is generated differently. So it makes the experience unique.
Very Minecrafty.
Yeah, we're going to head over to the Badlands next, but I've spotted something down on the forest floor that I want to show off first. So I'll head over here. This is the second thing that the allays do for you. This is an allay chest, and essentially the allays will keep these stocked with resources. You can find them in the world, crack them open, see what's inside. There we go. I got 107 diamond.
Thank you, allays.
That's right.
Okay, just casually get 107 diamonds. Can't these be in normal Minecraft? Okay, that would be a little bit too overpowered, but
Right, yeah. So that's cool. You're exploring the world and you find those chests around, be sure to open them up because the Illaes always have gifts for you. Here we are in the Badlands. So this is the second biome I wanted to show off.
Definitely okay. Not as friendly as the beautiful jungle.
Yeah, yeah. This one's a little bit more hazardous. We've got some red thorns over here. Be sure not to walk into those. Those can deal damage. And there's a lot less trees, so there's a lot less wood resource in this biome. So you have to keep that in mind when you're planning ahead.
Okay. Ooh, that doesn't look great over there.
No, it sure doesn't. This here is the Piglin base. Now you can see the portal over there and the corruption that is spread throughout the world from that portal. And that's why we're here to stop it. We got to destroy that portal so that this corruption doesn't spread any further.
I wonder if it will spread, though. That's a question I have. Is it actually going to spread? Like, that would be cool. It would be a little bit, maybe, stressful, but it also would be a cool mechanic to have.
Okay, now this is the last thing that I wanted to show that the Illaes can do. I'm going to switch my hotbar here.
Oh.
And I'm going to get the Illaes to build me a bridge. Do.
Okay.
I'm switch my hotbar here.
So he switched his hotbar to, I guess, a defensive kind of thing. And so he's able to make a tower, which is that thing over there, it seems. Wall, stairs. Okay, this is looking cool.
And I'm going to get the Illaes to build me a bridge across this river. One click, and off
they
go.
Wow. So we have the blue Illaes are gatherers, and then the yellow ones are building things.
That's exactly right.
And then they're both filling chests of awesomeness. I mean, they are really great.
Yeah, they sure
they are.
So I'm actually going to drop these friends off here. I don't want to bring them into battle. I don't want them to be hurt. Yeah, I'll be back for you later.
Ooh, what do we have here?
Okay, next is the spawners. So here we are. We've got a few of them. These are player-built structures, and there's one for each type of mob. And essentially, you build them, you get your Illaes to build them, and then you interact with them to spawn some mobs. So this is a creeper spawner. We're going to spawn ourselves a couple of creepers.
I would say I've never been happy to spawn creepers, but maybe today is the first time.
That's for sure. You know, we're all aware of how dangerous they can be, but when you use them against the piglins, they're extremely effective.
I guess the nether threat is so big that all the mobs in the overworld are coming together to fight this evil. I love it.
And these are some new mobs, which I love.
That's right. These are the grindstone golems. So I'll grab a few of those. And then next, I'm going to get a couple of the plank golems.
And the strategy really comes in when you're deciding which mobs should be fighting the piglin hordes, because you're doing it in different ways.
That's exactly right. So,
is that cake? Hold on. Is that cake over there on the table? It's that cake.
So what the player is going to do is they're going to come and check out the piglin base, much like this, see what sort of piglin units and piglin structures in the base, and then pick their mobs accordingly.
I see a lot of action, so we're going to head over to Lee
that
and go
great.
Like in the middle of battle.
We sure are.
Okay, here we go.
Yeah, Lee's riding across that bridge there. She's got a whole bunch of mobs with her.
Whoa.
She's going to send them into battle using the Banner of Courage.
Okay.
So that big piglin over there is a lava launcher. That is one of the most dangerous piglins you can find in the Horde of the Spore. This is a Horde of the Spore base. And that piglin, you really got to watch out for those. They can attack long range by shooting magma cubes at you. They can also do short range stomp attacks to destroy any mobs nearby.
And Lee has actually put her Illaes to work helping out building those towers.
That's
which is really cool to actually have more defense.
That's right. The towers that she's got on the left and right side of the bridge here, those are arrow towers. They're going to shoot arrows at any piglins nearby. So what we're doing here is we're essentially moving our way into the base, taking out the piglin structures, setting up structures of our own, battling the piglins, and making a safe path towards the portal in order to take it out. So send in a few more mobs in here on the lava launcher to try and take it out before we move in on the portal. Now, Lee's been being handed off the mobs from one of our other players, from Anna, and that's a key part of playing the game in Legends. You have to make sure to use teamwork, everyone working together against the piglins.
Okay.
Ooh, that lava launcher looks like it's in trouble.
Oh, it's in big
There's
trouble.
There's a lot of mobs there.
It's in big trouble, yeah. It doesn't have much time left.
I love this.
There it goes. Whoa. Lava launcher down.
Oh, nice. Okay.
Okay. Do you think we can take out this portal?
Oh, I know we can. Because we have a secret weapon.
Secret weapon? I want to see the secret
weapon.
Oh,
there's our secret
weapon. Yeah. Okay.
Coming in with the first of stone. See this giant mob behind him? Scooping up a boulder, flinging it into the portal.
Wow, that's okay.
Oh, and the health bar's already down so quick.
Oh, yeah, these piglins didn't know what hit them.
That's effective.
13%, nice. A couple more shots.
I love that what a frame. I love this mechanic where you, well, need to use strategy, essentially, to clear a way first, because if you bring up the rock-throwing golem first, most likely it's just gonna die very easily, right? So you need to kind of strategize how you can, like they said, clear a path and then use that strategy to get forward and actually finish the mission or finish the objective, right?
Hopla!
Great job, team!
Nice.
Okay,
GG.
So I'm going to ask this on behalf of myself and everyone else. When can we play?
Yes.
Yeah, that's the thing. I get that question all the time. My daughter, mm-hmm.
my... And my boys.
Yes. Hello.
Yeah. And I'm happy to tell you today that it's spring 2023. So.
Spring 2023, ladies and gentlemen, Minecraft Legends. We're going to be able to play it, hopefully. That's soon, then. That's actually not too far away. That's amazing. That's really, really cool. I love the look of the game so far. It looks amazing, and it looks really, really fun to play as well. That is amazing. I'm really, really looking forward to that. That is awesome. Soon TM indeed. That's sick.